there are three switches are there. I need to know the conducting state of these three switches. Okay, they will be either on or off. How many possible combinations are there? 8, 2 to the power 3, out of which 3 are completely on or 3 are completely off. Haan na? 0, 0, 0, all are off, 0, 0, 1, so on up to 1, 1, 1. There are how many possible combinations? 8 combinations. All are 0 means all are off. That means these three are on. That means A is connected to negative bus, B is connected to negative bus, C is connected to negative bus. All three points are at the same potential. So what is VAB? 0. What is B? Come on. A is also connected here, B is also connected here, C is also connected here. What is VAB? 0. What is BC? C. So all line voltages are 0. So phase voltages are also 0. So it is a 0 vector. All 3 are on. All 3 are on. A is connected here, B is connected here, C is connected here. Again 0. So now I have, there are 6 states. These are active states and we are 2 are null states. Null states. 2 are null states, 0, 0, 0 and 1, 1 more are null states and remaining 6 are active states. Active states. Okay. Now see, from the equivalent circuit approach also you can determine. Now I will show you. I think I must have taken the other. From the equivalent circuit, don't have to worry about VNO, GNO, whatever. See the circuit here. SCI is 1, SB is 0, SC is 0. What does it imply? Sir, what does this imply? Can you tell me the equivalent state of equivalent circuit of the inverter? For this combination, sir, take from here. Yeah, energy. Last bench. What is the equivalent circuit for this? Quick. What is the equivalent circuit? SCI is 1. So A is connected to positive. A is connected to positive. There is a load. There is a neutral. SB is 0, lower is on, so B is connected to negative, C is 0, again C is connected to negative, loads are balanced. Are you with me? Now what is VIN? Agartal, what is VIN? Quick, this is VDC, this is, two-third of VDC, Z, so Z by 2, so Z and Z by 2 VDC, so voltage here is 2 by 3 VDC, one-third VDC, okay. So what is another possible combination you have? See, there are, I said there are 6 possible combinations, out of which, see here, 1 upper on, 1 upper on, 2 lower on, or 2 lower on, 1 upper on. Now phases may differ, but the equivalent circuit is 1 upper on, 2 lower on, or 2 upper on, 1 lower on. When upper one, when 1 upper one is on, what is the voltage? 2/3 VDC, and these two are off, what is the voltage? Magnitude is 1/3, sign is negative. Ayana, sign is negative, 1/3, this is 2/3. So when this, when any two upper ones are on and one is off, what could be the voltage? What could be? Positive 1/3 and negative 2/3, negative 2/3, negative 2/3. Same equivalent circuit, same equivalent circuit. See here. So don't have to be VCN. 1 1, C is lower one is off, so that is the equivalent circuit. So this voltage is now, two third VDC minus, this is one third. So only the signs are different, magnitude is the same, two third and one third, that's all. Now you have to plot. See, assuming 180 degree conduction. What do you mean 180 degree conduction? What do you mean 180 degree conduction? Having turned on, that 180 degree conduction, having turned on, you keep it in that state for 180. Okay? Keep it on for 180. Continuous. So that's the reason we turned on a phase and kept on for 180 degrees. Okay. So a phase, so b phase should be turned on after 120. After 120, b comes in. After 240, c comes in. Okay. So vc zero looks something like this. So here you just see vs zero is positive, vb zero is lower negative, C upper. So upper, now I am plotting only VAN, I am not plotting VBN and VCN, that you can plot later. I will just teach you how to plot VAN. A is positive and C is also positive, two upper switches are on. So what is the magnitude of voltage? Sir, plus one third. Okay. From this 60 degrees, A is positive, B is negative, C is also negative, only one device is on, only one device is. So magnitude is two-third, sign is also plus, two-third. And next 60 degrees is A is positive, B is also positive, but then C is negative, so two devices are on, one-third. So hence the name six step operation. How many steps are there in one cycle? Six steps. What is the frequency of the predominant harmonic? What is the harmonic spectrum? Fifth and seventh. If you take the harmonic series, the fifth and seventh frequency. So I am connecting to the grid, is a 50 hertz grid. So frequency of the predominant harmonic is 250 and 350. I want to filter it. What do we do? I can use the LC filter, no issues. What's the problem? Why straight away go to pulse width modulated inverter? Yeah, maybe various limitations are there. You can use second order LC filter. There are being used. Okay, you can. A second one is what is the second alternative? How do I wave shape? See, my voltage, therefore I am telling output voltage of the inverter is non-sinusoidal. Now I want to make the current to be sinusoidal, because the current that I am feeding to the grid, after all the current that I am feeding to the grid should be sinusoidal. How do I make the current to be sinusoidal? Suppose, see, that is the reason, if I have an RL circuit, see here, then we will see how PWM helps. A DC is applied to an RL circuit, okay, if tau, time constant, is very large compared to T, or how does the initial portion of the current look like? Linear. Initial portion of the current is linear, linear. So what I'll do is, instead of keeping it having turned on, keeping it for 180 degrees, what I'll do is I'll have large number of pulses in this. Are you with me? How it also will say, we'll have a large number of pulses. I'm achieving two things. Okay, what are they? We'll see. There are large number of pulses. What will happen if there are large number of pulses? So what will happen is, I told you here. What will happen? All of us agreed that initial portion is linear. I will turn it on. So what will happen? Current increases linearly. Okay. Here it is off. What will happen? Current decays. Okay. Again it is turned on. Decays. So I can have almost a sinusoidal current. Almost sinusoidal current. See, I'll show it in the lab also. Waveform is not there. Extended waveform. If I extend it, you can see this for almost linear. I did not bring. If I extend this zone, you'll see that this is linear, decay, linear, decay, linear, decay. No, these are storage oscilloscope, pickup. Any question? If you do not have a question, I have a question. No, in the sense, see, I'm not able to understand one thing. If I give a sinusoidal voltage to this circuit, current is sinusoidal? Are you with me? I am giving this sort of a waveform to this circuit, current is again sinusoidal? Ayana. So what is your conclusion? RL circuit, you give any waveform, it will draw a sinusoidal current. Sir? I showed you and you told me sinusoidal. Now you are saying that it is non sinusoidal. No. Of course, one I can see this is what it is. It is sinusoidal. Almost sinusoidal. Is it sinusoidal or no? Bhagwan, no, come on. I don't think you can get a better sinusoidal than this. Okay, if I take an oscilloscope and supply you, this voltage itself is non sinusoidal. With the thanks to all these laptops, and this voltage itself is non sinusoidal. Okay. So what we can infer? What is our inference? What do we conclude? Sinusoidal current and sinusoidal current. What you can tell your students if they ask, sir, what is their phasor diagram? No. No, I don't. Maybe I don't know what my inference is. Looks like this waveform has a fundamental component which is sinusoidal, and it has a high frequency component. A very high frequency for which this circuit behaves like an open circuit. RL circuit, if the frequency of excitation is very high, how does it, what is the current due to that voltage? If the frequency of this supply is very high, this is almost an open circuit. So if I use this, I can use the superposition theorem, out of which one is 50 hertz current and is a very high frequency component for which this circuit does not respond, Is that okay? Now my question to you is, how do I choose this higher frequency? What should be the frequency of the so-called predominant harmonic that is present? How do I, higher the better? See, come on, I want, as the gentleman said, that current waveform looks to him is approximately sinusoid, not an almost sinusoid. Are you with me? To have a perfect sinusoid, the harmonic spectrum should be, one is 50 hertz, another one is a very high component, should tend. Okay, then only I may have a sinusoidal current, okay, which is just not possible. Okay, what should be the frequency of the predominant harmonic? Higher the better, which quantity will determine? Higher the better. So number of pulses will determine the switching frequency. Are you with me? Number of pulses will determine the switching frequency. Which quantity will determine what should be the switching frequency? Which quantity? How will I determine the switching frequency of the inverter? How will you decide what should be the switching frequency? No, it is the power rating and the type of devices. See, if you are designing a 10 kilowatt inverter and you are designing a 500 watt inverter, okay, so type of devices are the same. For a 500 watt inverter, you can afford to have, you may choose a higher switching frequency, because every time you switch, there is going to be on off losses. So as the power rating increases, switching frequency comes down. It is the power level that will decide. Any questions? The power level and the type of devices that will decide. No, see, it is like this. In a sense, you may say, there are various parameters. Suppose, okay, fine, let the switching frequency high, losses will increase, I will use a better heat sink cooling or something like that. Another thing is THD, total harmonic distortion. THD. Suppose you are feeding power to the grid as per certain standards. If the THD should be less than 5%, then you have no choice but to switch to a high frequency or use a filter. There are various guidelines you got. Not the thumb rule. Device 10 kilowatt inverter, maybe you can switch at maybe 10 kilowatts or so. But then is that sufficient? Then what are you going to do with the 10 kilowatt inverter? That will decide. If you are feeding to the in-grid, if the THD is less, yes. If you want to, you have to reduce the THD further, you have to worry about something else. Technology available for? Yeah, definitely. The so-called soft switched converter, let's say. We will see. What is the problem? As you increase the switching frequency, what happens? See, every time you switch, apart from the losses, see that voltage from 0 to, what is this voltage? VDC, I think DC link voltage, if you see, and what is the rise time? Now you can't, it can't be 0, it is almost turn on time, it is quite fast. See the dV/dt, see the dV by dt. Suppose if you are using this, this of course this load either this fan has to take, your load, so motor has to withstand. Are you with me? See the dV by dt, the motor winding has to withstand. Which parameter is there? Very, very high dV by dt, there are windings there. So interwinding capacitance, you heard about interwinding capacitance in a machine, come on, distributed capacitance, and there is a very high dV by dt, so capacitor charging discharge current will be very high, insulation background, all those issues are there. Is not only the losses. So the question is, how do I, we'll come to that, how do I reduce all these, the so called stress, not only the losses. Is the voltage across the device also, see this is the voltage across the, this is voltage across the conducting device. So in a voltage source inverter is complementary, isn't it? Whatever that happens, if this voltage goes from 0 to VDC, same voltage this also will be facing, isn't it? Come on, when this is on, instantly the entire voltage comes across it. When this is off, voltage across it is 0. So device voltage across the device also rises very fast, and the device stress also more. How do I reduce this device stress? How do I reduce this device stress? How do I reduce? There are issues, we'll see, come to that. Definitely. So retrofitting may not be a solution. I have a motor which is designed for a sine wave. Sine wave is a beautiful waveform. You can differentiate it, you can integrate it, you can still get a sine. Ayana. So motor winding, there is no transient at all. All of a sudden you have, that motor has been designed for 50 hertz sinusoidal supply. Now you are feeding this inverter output where the dV by dt is very high. dV by dt is very high. Now you need to really properly think, and only then you should go on for all this. If you are going to be inverter fed, it has to be, you may have to increase the insulation level, you may have to, this is a subject by itself, we will see, discuss later. Any questions? I do not know, that's typically what frequency it will run, I don't know, I will just give an example. What could be the switching frequency of a small SMPS that is used in a PC? What could be? Yes, of that order. What is the frequency of the inverter? See, we have a Rajdhani and Shatabdi trains, these are all AC locomotives, AC drive, there is an also an inverter. Power rating is of the order of, one rake is of the order of 1 MVA, thumb rule. One rake of the order of 1 MVA. What is the frequency? Switching frequency. What is the switching frequency? Of the order of 550 to 600 hertz. All depends on the switching frequency. Sorry, it all depends on the power level. And afterwards, what you do afterward? Will you put a LC filter? See here, in the sense, what I will do is, in the output voltage of this inverter is pulse width modulated. Output, if I am using pulse width modulation, output voltage is going to be pulses. Now if I want to feed a sinusoidal voltage, I can use a LC filter, filter it out and give, it is possible, there are various techniques possible. Or change the control strategy itself, change the power circuit configuration itself, maybe in my next lecture I will cover which is better, then you need to decide which is better. Yeah, just 5 minutes are there, I don't think I will start another topic. If you have any questions, feel free. Feel free.
Switches, MOS switches are designed for a 24 volts bi-level, multi-level inverter. It goes to MOS switches. We switch on the device by sending 5 volts to PK. And as per the theory, if we send 0 volts to gate at source, it should turn off. But the circuit doesn't turn off. Then we
no.
Circuit for
no. No, it doesn't. No, in the sense it will turn off. Turn off time is, see, how do you turn off the MOSFET? No, multi-level inverter we will discuss. That is the next topic that I have to discuss. Okay. This is a question on multi-level inverter. We will see when we discuss multi-level inverter.
Very popular MOSFET modulation technique is sinusoidal feedback technique. What is sinusoidal feedback technique? What is sinusoidal feedback technique? Sine is compared with transient. What is sinusoidal feedback technique? Other feedback technique is there. What is known as a selective harmonic feedback technique? Selective harmonic, what it says is, if there are n switchings per quarter cycle, listen to me, if there are n switchings per quarter cycle, n minus 1 harmonics you can eliminate and control the fundamental. It is not my theory, it is like this, in a sense, you write, I have a square wave, output voltage is a square wave, output voltage waveform is a square wave, okay, 180 degree. What is the harmonic spectrum? What is the harmonic spectrum in a three-phase system? 1, 5, 7, 11, 13, so on. Okay? So, what the Fidelin technique says, if there are n switches per quarter cycle, n minus 1 harmonics can be eliminated and fundamental can be controlled. So, if there are 6 switchings per quarter cycle, 5 harmonics you can eliminate. What are they? 5? 7, 11, 7, 11, 13, 17. These harmonics you can eliminate and the predominant harmonic that is present is 19. If there are 6 switchings per quarter cycle. So what is the question? No, how can I tell, is there a drawback or not? I don't know. The question is, predominant harmonic that is present is now 19. I don't know, sir. Who am I to tell it is allowed or not? Predominant harmonic that is present is 19. What is the frequency? 50 into 90, 950 hertz. No, sir. 950 hertz is the frequency of the predominant harmonic. Okay? Now, depending upon your circuit parameters, what is the current that it will draw from that 19th harmonic that you need to know? You follow what I am saying? No.
Now, there is one lecture on harmonic elimination. If you want me to give, I will give, but then you need to give me a slot. See, sir, this wave, if I write the Fourier series or whatever, first, 5, 7, 11, 13, so on. If there are 6 switchings, means 17. These harmonics are eliminated. Predominant harmonic is now 19th. Okay? So, what will be the equivalent circuit for the 19th harmonic? V19th and maybe R I can neglect if it is an RL circuit because L will be. This L will be now 19 into omega 1 into L. Hai na? Omega 1 is 50 fundamental, okay, 19 omega L. So, your impedance has increased by 19 times. So, depending upon the magnitude, it will drive some small current, I do not, it depends on L, no? It will drive some current. Now, that will affect your THD. So, will it be okay or not? It all depends on your circuit parameters and your THD. Suppose this won't do, then you may have to increase the switchings per cycle. It has, one has to take a paper and a pencil and write, is it sufficient or not? I can't say, is it okay, is it allowed or not allowed? Because one has to go as per certain standards. There are certain standards that will tell you. Good. Quick. Inverters are not recommended for refrigerator and what could be the reason? In the sense, one is what sort of air conditioner? Say the window air conditioner. No, but what could be the reason? Is it the interest current? Is the interest current? See, 1 kVA inverter, I use it for a 1 ton AC. This is my gut feeling, I am telling you. I do not know. Suppose I use a 1 kVA inverter for a whatever this one. What will happen when I put, when I turn on the air conditioner, what will happen? Initially huge inrush current, your inverter may not be able to supply. If the inverter is able to supply, why not? All the data centers, here, they are backed up by air conditioners, are backed up by UPSs. Air conditioners are there, backed up by UPS. But then I need to choose a high rating inverter. See, one way is we have to see what it could be the reason. One way is if the motor is done for 50 hertz, now you are feeding what sort of a voltage, some fast rising voltage that may affect your retrofitting is not possible. You should really think. Point number one. Are you with me? Yeah. The second is you can definitely use an inverter for AC. Choose a suitable rating. You can't say 1 kVA inverter, 1 ton is requires around this one, I can use it. No. Why you come to IIT? There are data centers, computer centers running continuously whether there is a power supply or not. You can. Anything else? We do not have a very stiff source. Now source is weak. It cannot, doesn't have a high capacity. So your devices may fail unless until you have overload capacity or you need to have a soft start. Yeah. What? What is HF means? What does that mean? It all depends on your THD and type of load, power rating. No. See, maybe those are all finer details. We'll discuss how to choose. What is the harmonic spectrum? See, which book you are referring? I don't know. But then, see, it all depends on. Frequency spectrum, it all depends on the frequency spectrum. N is multiple. So it requires time to discuss this, those so called finer details. Therefore, for a given number of pulses, what should be the harmonic spectrum? After all, it only depends on power level and what is the harmonic spectrum, harmonic content that a load that can withstand. That's all, nothing else.